Hey guys, welcome to the last and the final episode of Everything About Dual Degree. हमने सारी branches cover कर ली हैं, physics, chemistry, maths, bio, and it's time for MSc Eco. And we have Sobhra Datta with us. Now he's a YouTuber. He has a YouTube channel of his own with around 2.65k subscribers, and he is MSc Eco plus CS.
Hi Devansh. Really thank you for having me on the channel and just telling about me. I'm a Bisian and I'm, as he said, I'm already a YouTuber and I am doing a lot of freelancing these days. And freelancing in graphic design and video editing, a bit of UI UX design. So I'm just kind of exploding at this point of time.
Also, अगर मुझे कोई भी जैसे डिजाइनिंग टिप्स ही होती है, मतलब मुझे अपने थंबनेल्स काफी इंप्रूव करना है, तो मैं सीधा भैया को ही पूछता हूँ कि प्लीज हेल्प सब गाइड. अच्छा तो हाँ भैया, एक पहले आपसे एक स्पेशल क्वेश्चन. आप पहले एमएससी बायो थे, तो हाउ डिड यू चेंज एमएससी फ्रॉम एमएससी बायो टू एमएससी इको एंड एक प्लस सीएस? सो हाउ डज दैट डन?
ओके, सो उसके लिए आई वाज थिंकिंग ऑफ मेकिंग अ स्पेशल वीडियो ऑन दैट. मतलब ठीक है, लाइक टू गिव अ वेरी टू टेल यू ऑन अ ब्रीफली बोल देता हूँ मैं कैसे है. तो मोस्टली इट्स रियली हेवीली डिपेंडेंट ऑन योर फर्स्ट ईयर सीजीपीए. ओके, सो आई हैड अराउंड 8.6 आई गेस, एंड इट्स मोर लाइक द नंबर ऑफ पीपल हु आर अप्लाइंग फॉर अ ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम बी एक्स टू बी वाई. सो इट्स लाइक फ्रॉम वन डुअल डिग्री टू अनदर डुअल डिग्री. एंड इट्स हाँ, तो वही डिपेंड करता है कितने लोग अप्लाई कर रहे हैं. मोस्टली ओनली अराउंड 3-4 पीपल एक्चुअली कैन चेंज देयर ब्रांचेस. सो हाँ, तो कंपटीशन इज रियली देयर. एंड द कट ऑफ फॉर इकोनॉमिक्स ट्रांसफर फॉर हाँ द कट ऑफ फॉर इकोनॉमिक्स वाज अराउंड 8.5 एंड आई वाज द सेकंड गाय टू गेट द ट्रांसफर. देयर वाज वन पर्सन अबव मी एंड वन पर्सन बिलो मी. तो हाँ, तो इट्स मोस्टली अबाउट सीजीपीए एंड ऑल्सो अबाउट अ राइट अप. देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड अ राइट अप व्हिच नो वन टॉक्स अबाउट. And you need to mail to Pilani campus. This is not done by Goa campus. It's this all the branch allotment happened from the Pilani campus itself. And so you need to make a write up, telling why do you want to change the branch. And if you actually screw up in write up, even after having a good CGPA, you might not get a transfer. So it happened with one of my friends. So you need to be really cautious about that. So that's how it happens.
Thanks a lot. Now let's start with what are the courses that you took under MSc Eco. How was your second, third year going in MSc Eco?
Yeah, so mostly talking about dual degree students, it's like second year is the time when you have a bit of relaxation, because in the first year you have worked a lot hard and tried to get the the branch of your dream, or maybe even having a good CGPA is enough to just have the choices that you want to take. And for the second semester, I would just refer to the chart that I have here, and I will tell the subjects that I had. It's so in year 2 same one I had like EVS, that's a CDC. First I'm talking about the CDCs. So I'm just going to talk a little bit about the courses that we have in the second year itself. So there are obviously 2 semesters in a year. So in the first semester we have something called CDCs. CDCs are basically the compulsory disciplinary courses and which we have to do anyway. So these are the CDCs that we have here. That's EVS. Obviously, EVS doesn't have a proper grade. It's like good or bad, so it doesn't matter much. Then we have something called POE. POE is the principle of economics. Then we have FUFA. FUFA is fundamental of finance and accounting. Then there is MSM. MSM is mathematic and statistic method. Then we have EEB. It's economic environment of business. And there is M3. M3 is like maths 3. So you can see how many units does it make, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 18 units, right? So a dualite can max out around 25 units. So you can take around, I guess, 2 more, I guess. 1800.
Yes, two more.
So you can take around 2 more DELs or HELs. So HELs stand for humanities and DELs stand for disciplinary electives. So just talking about this, these courses are really enjoyed. Like if you are interested in economics, these are really, these courses will really interest you. And I guess this is a very good starting point for anyone going into finance or like might be interested in finance. So you can get a bit of idea like what finance is. again, like finance is not economics, to be very honest, and there are some differences, but to have a finance degree, finance minor, sorry, you need to know certain economic courses. So that's how it is. So this is the year 2 sem 1 and this is the year 2 sem 2. You can see, you can add more dels, because dualites mostly try to max out so that they can have a year long PS in their fifth year. The entire year can be a PS2. So that's why they try to max out their overload every semester. So overloading is more like, you know, having around 24 to 25 credits maxing out every semester. So these are the courses. So in 2-2, it's like EM, econometric methods, which is more like mathematics and lot of maths, lot of statistics in that. And even microeconomics, macroeconomics, micro has a lot of maths, macro is interesting. Then we have EGD, economic and growth and development. And then we have principle of management. Like lot of these courses are some sort of an intersection, like lot of these concepts are being used in some other subjects and something like that. But these are really interesting courses. Same way you can max out.
Yeah, amazing. Okay, so what about the third year courses that you are doing in MSc Economics?
In third year, the courses are like MBFM, IED, and IE. It's like International Economics Issues in International Economics and other Money Banking and Finances. So these are the three. Because 3-1 is very hectic for every dualites, we don't have any additional slots for getting a DEL or getting a HEL. So it's almost all the credits are maxed out in the third year and the first, third year first. So it's like 23 credits.
Okay. So yeah, that was it with the courses. Let's talk about the scope of MSc Economics. So aapne se switch kiya tha branch from MSc Bio to MSc Eco. So why was that? And if I take MSc Eco, what all options are, gates are getting opened for me, and what career paths?
Yeah. So the transfer I took was not really because there was more scope in this economics, and I don't want to demean any other branches at all because there are scopes in every branch. But it's more of a personal choice that I took to. The transfer was a personal choice. So there are a lot of differences that economics have to put forward when you compare with healthcare. So with using other duals, you can get a lot of opportunities in research sectors, right? But unlike other duals, which are more research oriented, you can get into research fields using those. But I guess when you're in economics, it's a very interesting dual. It's a very practical branch to me, and you can also sit for placements. Like, I guess it is the only dual branch through which you can sit for placements independent of your second branch. Okay. Independent of your dual. So that is a very big thing. And for that, there are companies like Credit Suisse, JP Morgan, Goldman Sachs, all the big names in the industry of the finance companies that come for the placement. The placement for this finance companies are a bit different, actually. Like a lot of people don't know. As far as I know, like they don't come directly for placements. It's like they come for internships. Okay. So what you have to do is mostly you have to actually complete all the finance related courses first. So it's a bit complicated. It's like the single degree students can do finance minor, right? So they have to do complete all the 5 to 6 DELs of finance. So the best part about an economics dual is like you can almost mimic the finance minor without having a finance minor. So that's the biggest pro, that you can actually sit for this placement. So for these placements, you have to complete all this before the fifth year. That's very crucial. You have to do all the necessary DELs, 6 DELs before the fifth year, and then you can go for a PS2. PS2 is like practice school. You obviously know. In practice school, you can go for internships in these companies. And then if they like your work, you can get a PPO. PPO is like a pre-placement offer. And that's how you get placed in this like finance companies. I guess that's the best part about economics. And other benefits are also there. Like if you go into your MBA later on, it might be helpful in that regard.
Okay, yeah, so apart from basically, just to summarize, engineering, apart from engineering, finance opens a lot more doors and opportunities in which you can still explore if you don't want to be a part of the core engineering aspects of engineering.
Switch
to other fields using a.
Best part is if you have, you can actually sit for both your degrees. Like you can sit for the place for both the degrees. Like you can go for finance also. If you have a CS, you can sit for IT sector also. But then there is this criteria that you have to complete other DELs.
Yeah, makes sense. Can you tell us about the free time you get in your second and third year to explore other opportunities? For example, you are a great graphic designer and you explored that field a lot. So would you give any advice and tips on that? So how much free time do you get to explore other fields of your choice?
So it's kind of a myth. Like we have a lot of free time. Economics people have a lot of free time. So the thing is that people always say that economics is an easy branch. Grading is very good. To be honest, grading is actually good. And because grading is good, everyone gets the average is also very high. So you actually need to still keep studying in your second year. But obviously it's much, you have a lot of time in your second year. Yes, you definitely have a lot of time in your second year and you can explore a lot of stuff. I actually, at the cost of my CGP, I did explore a lot. Like in my second year, I tried to explore video editing to my maximum potential, then this graphic designing, then I tried to go into freelance and then work. I guess editing for startups and a lot of stuff I tried to explore, and that did negate some of my CGP. But I guess it's fine to explore because, I mean, to be honest, during college you need to explore, you need to meet a lot of people, you need to go for networking, you need to go for events, and this is the best time because Dualite will have the second year as the only time to explore. So I guess that's the tip, is to not negate your studies, because scoring in economics, as I realize now, is not a very difficult thing to do. You need to have really good friends so that they can help you out when you are struggling and stuff, but also, you also have time.
Quick shout out. If you guys want to know about the freelancing stuff and graphic designing and video editing, just follow, I'll link his channel in the description. You can just visit his channel and pakka say you like the content that he puts up. So yeah.
Thank you.
Fine. Having covered that, so a lot of people were actually wanting to know how to get CS. So MSc Eco plus CS is one of the, let's say, the best combination out there for any Dualite, right? Be it, I've talked to even my friends a lot, and everyone feels that MSc Eco plus CS is like the dream combination. How did you manage to get CS in your first year? What all, any tips for the freshers, your juniors?
Okay. So, what I followed was very practical. I realized that I am an average student. I'm not like someone, the best at everything. So I tried to optimize stuff. Really, I went into calculations. Like, these are the subjects that I have, and these are the subjects that, and this is the grade I need to get so that I can at least get a computer science degree. Since my target was not to get a CS, rather to get a branch transfer, so it wasn't very difficult for me to get CS. But for others, I would say is to very much optimize in subjects. Like, there will always be like labs. Okay, right. So what I always preferred was I'm giving an example, like manlo 3 labs, theek hai, 1 unit each. Now I try to get A in all of this, because getting A in labs is easier than getting an A in something like maths or something like prostats. Okay, so I try to optimize stuff like that, where I know that I can't get a minus or an A in like prostat, because it's like around F plus 110 or some crazy stuff. So I knew I had to optimize. So I put only that much time in prostats so that I can get a B, and all that other time I optimized to get A's in all the labs, and also some in other subjects I tried to optimize like that. I went into a lot of calculations, like what all combinations I can make to like, so that I can be very much efficient, like minimum efforts and maximum results, basically. So that's how I did it.
Smart work, yeah.
A lot of people need to get into that.
Yeah. anything you would want to add? I'm done with my questions. अगर आपको कुछ लगता है मैंने miss किया तो आप सीधा add.
I guess anything that I would like to add is like really make good friends, because in first year I really missed the chance of making friends when they come, and in the second year it was a lot difficult to get into friends, but I eventually, you know, made a lot of friends and get to start. But don't get into the grind at the very beginning. Like, come on man, just explore. You just gave your JEE and you're coming to the college, so explore a bit, but don't neglect your studies obviously. And for CS, I guess it's not very hard to do it if you are really consistent. Yeah, I guess consistency is a very big thing. I used to like have this calendar thing, like in calendar everything would be organized, when I have my classes, when I would go for a break, when I would do exercises, when I would study, when I would visit library. In my first year I was like very organized. So I guess this, if you build systems around you, it's very easier to, you know, things won't be so much overwhelming to me.
That's it. Yeah, great advice.
Devansh is also coming up with really good stuff, and you know, he's trying to help out all this aspirants, because he's making these videos on each brand specific. These are really helpful and giving insights, right? So make sure you subscribe to his channel, because he's pushing out really great content.
Thanks a lot. Really beautiful.